to heart fund. Many heart patients in this country suffer a lot because of the heart disease. But in addition to that, the mental trauma that occurs because of the anxiety that is associated with the inability to get proper treatment adds on to their suffering. It is with this in mind that Dr. Raj De Silva, consultant cardiologic surgeon of Sri Jayawardenepura, and myself, Dr. Ruvanneka Nayakar, who is the retired senior cardiologist from the National Hospital of Sri Lanka, decided to start a fund which will help patients to get appropriate therapy as speedily as possible. We know that many patients who are financially deprived are helped by the President's Fund. Unfortunately, the help that comes from that aspect is limited to 150,000 rupees. This is inadequate to tide them over the full expenditure that is incurred for surgery. Therefore, even if we help them partially, the patient is not ultimately helped because they are still short of funds to get proper treatment. So with this in mind, we decided that whatever deficient funds are there for these particular patients, needy patients who are unable to raise funds or have no financial resources which to tap, we will give them the rest in full so that they can have their surgeries done and then come back to a normal productive life. We are concentrating on patients who are breadwinners, who have small children still being educated, and who have got into this mess of having ischemic heart disease through no fault of their own. And it is for this type of patients that we have extended our hand of friendship. So the Heart Part Fund primarily aims to have the surgery done at Sri Jayawardenepura Hospital and not elsewhere, because the National Hospital is already full. The government sector is already full up, and we can't do any more cases there for the simple reason that the resources are limited, and even if we add on cases, what will happen is the patients on the waiting list will get delayed. We can't do it in the private sector because the private sector is always profit motivated, and therefore the expenditure incurred will be higher. Jayawardenepura is therefore an ideal situation where these patients can have their surgery done at a very nominal cost, and therefore we thought we will help these patients to get their surgery done at the Sri Jayawardenepura Hospital, where excellent surgical services are available.